Cubist and Dada artists had begun to use found objects in their work in the early decades of the 20th century. This use of objects that were not constructed by the artists themselves allowed artists to both challenge the notion of fine art as well as bring aspects of the real world into their work. In 1918, Kurt Schwitters had introduced attaching bits of debris, wood, and garbage to his paintings. He called this approach Merz, a nonsense word that he used to describe his process. In 1923, he began to enlarge this idea by converting a room in his house in Hanover into a living art environment. The room was completed in 1933 and eventually expanded to 6 rooms, which he called Merzbau. Concurrently, in Russia, a group of artists inspired by the Russian Revolution's promise of a new utopia wanted to create a new art for social and political change. Utilizing architecture, graphic design, and visual art, they wanted to bring a new aesthetic into all aspects of life. Following his teacher, Kazimir Malevich's ideas that art should express the supremacy of pure artistic feeling, an artist known as L. Lisitsky created a type of art he called Prun. Lisitsky's theories eventually took three-dimensional form in his Prun Room. These early attempts to merge life and art inspired many artists who came after. Some artists began to fill spaces with both made and found objects, where the experience of the entire space became the artwork. Known as installation art, this work takes many forms. Most people are used to viewing paintings hanging on a wall and sculpture on stands in a gallery or museum. An installation exploits an entire space, so the viewer's involvement is different. Installation artists elicit, consensually or not, the viewer's participation, and those behaviors or reaction become part of the artwork. Sometimes, when a viewer interacts with the art, they are guided to certain experiences. Other times, the interactions are spontaneous and variable. Artists have used installations to explore aspects of nature, psychological states, politics, and social conditions. Some installation art is site-specific, meaning it was made for a particular space. Other installations move from place to place and adapt to the space in which it is situated. Installations occur both indoors and out, can be expansive or intimate. Installation art often combines many different sensory experiences like sound, touch, and even taste. Much postmodern art defies easy classification. The boundaries between performance art, conceptual art, and traditional media like painting and sculpture are fluid in many installation works. Art that is called installation often combines all these art elements and includes non-art media as well. New technologies, industrial processes, and complex structural engineering sometimes play a role in installation art. Installation art has become a favorite genre for many contemporary artists. So much so that the artists in this video only scratch the surface of artists who use this approach. No doubt, innovation in the ways artists connect art and life will continue to evolve.